lighting. Is this better? Is this better? Is this better? Hey there! We're back. Good to see you guys again. It's Wednesday and we are not allowed to open yet. Darn it. Yep, so Governor Abbott, he came out, gave the announcement that most all retailers and such can open, restaurants and these types of things. So good job for all of you. I'm very excited that we're going to have some restaurants that we can visit and get some variety going on what we eat. But for gyms and for hair salons and these types of things, we're still closed. But hey, at least we're moving in that direction to be able to open. So we're still very positive. Slightly bummed. But I think in general, we're on the right path. So today we're going to go into our class. We're going to get right into it. We are still looking for some feedback that people are actually watching these videos. I think we've gotten a few of you guys to respond. So we appreciate that because we really do want to, to keep the classes going. But of course, if it's not really hitting the mark, then maybe we need to make some adjustments. Maybe see whether or not it's really, making the difference that we're hoping for. So please, if you're watching this, please let us know if you indeed enjoy them and if you're getting your workouts completed. Because one thing, if you just want to watch us joke around and you're just sitting there on your couch, then you must be really bored. But hopefully you're getting inspired to get up, move around, and stay healthy. So please let us know. And we'll continue. If we get that response, we'll continue to run the classes and do what we can. So yeah, that's it for that. So let's go ahead and get the music going and let's get our stretches in place. So get you guys all nice and limber. It's not so nice outside, so the lighting is a little bit off, not the same, but hopefully you should be able to see everything, okay? All right, coming on down. Good. Oh, that feels good. I need this. Over the other side. Good. Over here. All right. Now, coming up. Oh, lower back. Woo. Rotating. I will miss all the dancing, but anybody that knows the classes that we run in this club, we're always dancing. All right, coming up, leaning over. Good. Now, for those of you who don't know, when we run the classes in the club, we use heart rate monitors to watch and judge how everybody is doing when it comes to the exercises, if they're really pushing themselves, how their body is responding to the exercises. It allows myself and the other trainers to be able to push the pace or to slow it down, to be able to customize the workouts and the intensities for the people that are in the classes. And it also allows us a very objective way to be able to motivate people based on real data, as opposed to just trying to read cues or body language as people are working out. And so the nice thing is that with what we call the MyZone technology, which is the people who come up with the heart rate monitors and the approach and systems to be able to monitor your heart, there's color bands and such that allow us to say, hey, okay, if you're in these color bands, let's say doing an exercise like squats or froggers or burpees, something like that, then we want to see that you get into the yellow range or into the red range, which is really at the higher end of your ability of your heart to pump. So how many beats per minute? And if you're up in the, in the 90 to 100% range, then you're going to be in the red. If you're in the 80 to 90%, you're going to be in yellow of your max heart rate. And so we're able to push people based on those types of exercises and what we think based on our professional opinion, where those heart rates should be for that particular person. And it allows us to be able to push them into those ranges. And everybody gets points, so go ahead and bring your shoulders up and roll them back. You get points for the amount of time per workout that you spend in these different zones. So if you're in the green zone a lot, then you get a certain number of points. If you're in the yellow zone, those upper zones, yellow and reds, you get more points. Coming back the other way. So this is, again, another objective way for us to be able to say, hey, based on your age, height, and weight, that in this workout, you've been able to accumulate this many effort points. And we, you know, track that over a period of time, and you're able to, yeah, see how you're doing. In comparison to other people who are different ages, different weights, male, female, all that's taken into consideration, then you can really judge, you know, how you're doing as far as your effort in comparison to someone else. It's also a lot of motivation. All right, so what we're gonna do, hopefully you're motivated to get going this workout. We're gonna start off with some warm-ups, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna be doing some, Sarah's gonna come into this because she makes all of this look much better. But we're gonna go in and we're gonna do some walking modified push-ups. We're gonna do some hamstring curls. We're gonna be doing some jumping jacks and some lunges, okay? So Sarah, go ahead and show us what this first exercise is going to be.
Okay, so you go down, walk your hands out, drop your knees, and do a modified push-up. Pick your knees up, walk your hands back, over and over.
So this is a walkout with a push-up with modified, right? So you don't have to worry about doing a full push-up. Remember, we're just warming up. So for everybody out there, if you want to do a modified push-up on your knees, it's great. If you want to just go ahead and jump right into a push-up, no problem. Then we're going to do is go into hamstring curls. We're going to be doing kind of a sidestep. And make sure your arms are coming out and then in, okay? If you want to make this a little more challenging, you can grab some small dumbbells or some Jiffy peanut butter jars, and you can go through and use that for to add some more resistance and some weight. Then we're going to move into some jumping jacks. Again, if you need a modification, we're going to be going to doing our half jacks, okay? Get those arms moving. And then for the last one, stepping lunge, you're going to step forward and then you're going to step back. Same leg, okay? We're going to go for 30 seconds on one side, and then we're going to switch 30 seconds on the other leg, all right? This is going to be our warm-up. We're going to go and do each of these 30 seconds. We're going to go through that two times for our warm-up, and then we're going to move right into our circuits where we're going to start with some squats. We're then going to move up to some, you know, up to our upper body push-ups. We're going to move back down to our body in lunges, and then we're going to get into some shoulder work. And then, of course, once we're at the end, we'll get into Sarah's ab corner. And yeah, that's for sure. That we're saving the best for last. Okay, everybody ready? All right, here we go. We're going to be doing our walkouts with a modified push-up or for a regular push-up. All right, everybody ready? Here we go. 3, 2, 1, go. Walk yourself back out. Coming up. Down, modified, push, back up, good. I gotta slow down. Going too fast. Woo! Feeling so good. 3, 2, 1, last one. Oh yeah, finish it out strong. Coming back. Good job. Okay, now we're gonna be doing our hamstring curls. Ready? Here we go, up. Good. Yeah, remember the warm-up is definitely different than the normal workout. We're just getting the blood flow. We wanna make sure that we get good movement in our lower body, stretch out those tendons and ligaments, get those muscle fibers loosened up. And of course, we want the same for our upper body and just to get ready so we reduce the risk of injury. And yeah, it's good for overall workout. Get that warm up in there. All right, and relax. Good. Now we're gonna go into jumping jacks. Remember, half jacks. Good. Sarah's doing the full-on workout. Really pumping it up. I think Sarah has her heart rate monitor on.
I do.
Of course, it wouldn't be appropriate to be showing it to you right now. But it does sit right here underneath your shirt, right on the skin, and it's there that it helps, yeah, tracking your heart rate. And then it's connected to an app on your phone, or if you're in the club, it connects to the system in the club. And relax, good. Now we're going into our front and reverse step, coming forward and down and then back. Now remember, we're doing both legs, so just focus on one side at first. Good.
know what I say, if you're having a hard time with balance, touch in the middle first. And then go.
Now we're off. Oh, there, oh, we're back on.
Did that confuse you?
Good. Almost there, we're gonna switch legs, okay? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good, other leg. Nice. Woo. The day that we're recording this, which is Tuesday, and you're watching this, this is Wednesday, I think the weather will be about the same. It's pretty cloudy outside. Here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, now we're going into our walkouts. Ready? 3, 2, 1, go. Modified push-up, down and up. Coming back up, standing position. Good work.
Like a little kid crawling on the floor. Very functional training.
We just vacuumed the floor, so it's okay.
Yeah, that's true.
Here we go, last one. Make it a good one. Good. All right, here we go. Hamstring curls. Ready? Good.
Get a good pull. Bring those shoulder blades together.
So we think, based on what Governor Abbott said, that the club would likely be open to some degree what looks like Monday, May 18th. We think there'll be an announcement before then, the week prior to that. So maybe on the 15th or the 14th, there would be an additional press conference that would then specify that, okay, relax. Now going into jumping jacks and go. So that's about 3 weeks away from Monday, which would be day before yesterday for you. And so we're very hopeful. We're not, you know, like I said, we're not too down or anything like that. We think this is a good opportunity for the authorities, those that are handling the testing for the virus, to continue to get things under control and relax. All right, now we're stepping lunges and go. And it also allows us to be able to work further on the clubs, get them ramped up a bit more, make sure all the cleaning is ready, that we've got all our procedures in place. We will do a video on what the expectations are for the cleaning, especially for members as they come into the club. One new thing that we've implemented, or we expect to implement, is that everybody will be required, go ahead and relax, other leg, and go. Every member will be required to bring their own gym towel in, hopefully clean, but you should bring your own gym towel in. And this is not just a little towel, you know, to wipe your sweat. This is intended for you to put on the equipment, so on the machines, wherever your body would touch. And you would basically take that around to the different machines that you'd be using. And our hope is that that will create some separation between you physically and those machines, thus further reducing and relax, thus reducing the amount of contact and transfer of any bodily fluids from one person to the next. Of course, all the cleaning procedures and such, pretty well known in the club. We've been pretty good at that. It's already well adapted into our culture, but we'll just reinforce that, okay? But there'll be a video that'll be coming on all of those steps, and hopefully that makes everybody in the Katy area that are members, or even those that are non-members, comfortable with how we handle that. All right, so here we go. We're gonna be going into our lower body squat portion. We're gonna be doing narrow squats. So you're gonna come down, feet semi-close together, coming down, and then you're gonna bring your legs out for the next rep, down, and then you're gonna go wide, and then down, and then you're gonna go back together, close, down. All right, ready? Here we go, ready? 3, 2, 1, narrow squat. Good. Now remember, for this circuit, this is three exercises. The expectation is for all of you that are going after an hour workout is that you would be doing each of these circuits twice. And here we're going for 45 seconds per exercise within the circuit. Okay? Good. Got about another 10 seconds. And then we're gonna go into our sort of our mid stance, our normal neutral stance. And here we go, neutral stance. Ready? 3, 2, 1. I'm holding a really heavy stopwatch.
Yeah.
This is my resistance. Now remember, if you're not able to get that low on the squat, right, then just drop down to about right there. Create that activation on those quadriceps. And then just work to try to get a little deeper, okay, as you get better, as your flexibility improves. Most people that aren't able to get this low, it's not because they're not able to. I mean, of course, if you have an injury or something like that, it precludes you, that's understandable. Here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good, coming out. Nice and wide, and go. But a lot of times, it's because of the mobility or lack of mobility in our hips. And so you can do a lot of specific stretches to be able to increase that mobility, to get lower. And as you get lower, the muscles that are activated start to change, or at least the muscles that are doing a lot of the work start to change. So as you're doing, you know, let's say ranges where you're in the top half, or the three quarter of an entire squat, it's a lot of quadriceps. You start activating hamstrings and glutes, but for a lot of it, it's quadriceps. And relax. Okay, now remember, you're gonna go back to those exercises one more time, 45 seconds each. Just to finish that off, as you start to get lower in your squat, you activate more glutes and hamstrings. For all of you ladies that are looking to build your backside a bit more, then the lower you get, the better off you're gonna be, okay? All right, we've got some other exercises that can focus on that if you're not able to do low squats. But here we're gonna now switch into a new type of push-up. We're gonna call this a warrior push-up. This is actually where you're gonna bring your elbows close to your side and you're gonna press up. All right, Sarah, you ready? Here we go, 3, 2, 1. Go. Now Sarah has a plate. It's one of the plates that we have here in our home. Of course, you can opt to choose anything that you feel like you can handle. They would add, let's say 8 to 10 pounds to provide enough resistance for you. Remember, we're going 45 seconds. The nice thing about this is anybody that has pre-existing shoulder issues, this exercise is useful because it shouldn't aggravate these pre-existing shoulder issues too much. Not as much as a typical floor press or push-up might when your elbows are more flared out. Okay, here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good. Now Sarah's gonna flip over and we've got another slightly modified chest movement. So we've got a push-up, but this is going to be a narrow position. You're gonna actually turn your hands in so it creates a little bit like a diamond, okay? And then the elbows are gonna come straight out, just like that, and then she's only gonna go halfway down. Okay, clock's running. Go down just a little bit more, right there and up. Yes. This is where you'll fully activate the tricep, because that's what these narrow, push-ups are for, is going after that tricep, while of course you still have some activation of chest going on there. So I'm sure Sarah can feel that in her chest, but she can also really feel it in her triceps. Good. Keep it up. We got another 15 seconds. Good. Good job, Sarah. Now, for all of you that are a bit more machismo, then you can certainly come off of the floor with your knees and do a standard narrow stance hand push up and relax, Sarah. Good. All right, now, that was really a great example of different modifications to a standard push-up or to a standard floor press, or bring your elbows in, that warrior push, okay? And then flipping over and doing like a diamond push-up or semi-diamond push-up. Okay, so now we're gonna move back to our lower body. I'm gonna go ahead and bring this camera angle up a bit. Now we're gonna do is we're gonna go into lunges with a kick. So Sarah's gonna go ahead and get a lunge, and then she's gonna come forward with a kick. And then once we're done with that, we're then gonna go into a squat with a lunge, or with, squat with a lunge, and we're gonna have a overhead press as you come back in that lunge, okay? Working our shoulders, but it also puts a lot of tension and resistance on our posterior chain as we really stretch up and have to maintain that balance as we're going up. So really a fantastic exercise. Okay, you ready? Okay, here we go. We've got lunges with a kick. Now I'm gonna be just doing a normal lunge with a kick. Ready and go. Sarah's gonna be doing a bounce with a kick. I'm doing, of course, the modification. Woo! Good. Nice. We're going for 45 seconds, and then we're gonna come switch to the other side. Woo! Good.
You got the feeling?
I got the feeling that my legs are burning. They must be just smoking on your side. Okay, 3, 2, 1. Woo, we got a lot of lunges in this one. But anybody that knows lunges, anything knows about their lower body, lunges are fantastic, great isolation movement. Okay, ready, and down, and up. Also improves balance. And you really gotta focus. Whereas in more of a stationary exercise, you can let your mind wander a little bit. In fact, even as I'm talking to you right now, I'm having to really switch between what I'm gonna say to you and focusing on where my feet are gonna plant so that I don't fall over. Yeah, like just there. I almost fell over. Come on, we're almost there. Woo! Ooh, Sarah's breathing hard. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Last kick. Good. Okay, now we're gonna go into our squat with an overhead press. Again, you can use a plate. You can also use peanut butter jars. Oh, yeah, I'm gonna stick with the jars of peanut butter. I wanna be like you guys. Actually, I just don't want to lift that heavy weight. Okay, all right. You ready? All right. Here we go. Ready? 3, 2, 1, go. You notice the opposite leg? Good. Oh.
What?
I almost missed that. I gotta go faster now. Catch up with her. Good. This is definitely one that I don't recommend having a conversation while you're doing it. Woo! Good. This is another exercise where mobility is important, especially in your shoulders. We don't realize just how much that mobility is needed. Okay, 5 more seconds. Last one. Last one. Whoop, I did that wrong. All right, good.
I messed up on the last one.
Yeah, whenever we're doing presses overhead like this, see our mobility, how far we can actually bring our shoulders back is very important. When we're doing a squat, you notice that if I'm doing a squat and I'm only able to bring my shoulders back this far, I do a squat and you notice how I come forward. So creating more mobility in our shoulders is important for doing some of these exercises. All right, so what do we have next? We've got side raises, lateral raises with the weights. Everybody ready? These are pretty benign. We should be able to get through these without any problems. Okay, ready? Here we go. Up. Now you notice that Sarah was in a scissor stance. So she was like this.
Like that.
Which is good. And what I would do when I'm in this position is that I'm leaning forward, so most of my weight is on my front foot. And this just helps with stability front and back, okay? A lot of times when you're doing heavier weight, that stability front and back is important, because as you're coming up, you can easily kind of go backwards and forward as you're kind of rocking, all right? So the scissor stance is useful as the weight gets heavier. Okay, 3, 2, 1. All right, now we're gonna do a combination. We're gonna do a curl, overhead press, tricep extension, down, curl, press, tricep extension. Good, ready? Okay, here we go. Curl, press, tricep extension, down, curl, up, tricep, overhead press, down, curl.
Again, if you're having problems as you go back, keeping your balance, you can always do that kickstand. Or maybe it's not too much weight, but maybe you're just fatigued and you need extra help. Mm-hmm. So always an option.
Press, tricep, curl.
Bicep.
Press, tricep, curl. There you go, good.
Part two of the curl.
Okay, here we go. 3, 2, 1. Nice work. Okay, now that may take a little bit to get used to that particular movement. Remember, you're coming up, you're curling, pressing overhead, and then elbows in, coming down, overhead extension. Okay, very good one. All right, so now we're gonna do is we're gonna go into, what do we have down
cardio
here?
Cardio.
Oh.
Happy feet, like this. My feet are so happy.
I need to go, go to the bathroom for the next 3 minutes. Okay, let's do this. All right, ready? We're gonna do some happy feet. Sarah's running in place. That's exactly what that is. Then we're gonna do a pendulum kick with weighted hands. So one thing you wanna do is you wanna have your Jiffy peanut butter or your dumbbells with you. And then we're gonna move into froggers. It was the froggers that made me wanna go to the bathroom. Scared the out of me. Okay, all right, you ready? Okay, so here we go. Happy feet, 45 seconds. Go as quick as you can. Remember, if you can't, just sit there and run in place, okay? Ready, 3, 2, 1, go. Just adjust the speed, adjust the height of those knees if you need to, okay? If you wanna make it more difficult, obviously increase your pace. Yeah, if you just need to slow it down, no problem. Good. Keep pushing.
Woo! She called this energetic feet, or too much caffeine feet.
I like it. Nice.
Oh, this is the bathroom dance.
Yes. Okay, here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, now we're gonna go ahead with the weighted. All right. That takes a little bit of coordination. So as you're coming over, the leg is coming over as the arm is going up. So if it's my right arm going up, my right leg is going out. Okay? And remember, you're just adjusting your pace based on your capability. So if you want to go faster, slow it down as you need to, okay? Good. Let's keep pushing it. We got one more after this. Froggers. And for all you overachievers, you're gonna go back and do this again. Yeah. Good. Keep it up. Woo! Nice job, Sarah, getting a good workout.
Yeah.
Good. Here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Nice. Okay, now we got froggers. We're gonna go ahead and get rid of those weights. Froggers are good enough without any weight.
Oh yeah.
Okay, you ready? Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Coming down and up. Up. Good. Woo! Nice. You know what makes this so challenging? It's this part where you come down and up, obviously. But that head movement can cause people problems. A lot of people find themselves getting sick as they do a lot of these. This is also true with burpees. Your head going up and down, body going up and down, can really disrupt how your body feels, especially if you just ate something. Here we go, 5 more seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. Nice work. Okay, for all of you, go back and do that again. Great exercises there. All right, and we're gonna go ahead and start up right now with Sarah's ab corner. So she's got 4 great exercises for you. Let's go ahead and let her take over.
Okay.
I'm gonna go to the bathroom now.
Oh my God. Give me the stopper. Okay, so first one, we're gonna do, still breathing heavy. We're gonna go back to some tricep extensions, but while we're doing a crunch. So, looks like this. Okay. Lift it up, extension, and back down. Up, extension, back down. Now, as you're coming up, it's gonna be hard. The heavier the weight is, the harder it's gonna be to come up. So don't beat yourself up if you're barely lifting off the ground. If all someone can slide under you is a credit card, that's okay, you're lifting something. So let's do that one for 30 seconds. Here we go. Up, extension, extension. Tyron, you're not in the restroom. I think he just wanted a drink.
Are you doing 30 seconds or 45?
Well, I said 30, but...
Okay, and you're done.
If you want us to do 45, we can.
I think
we
should
do
45.
We can do it.
I think we should do a minute. Minute and a half.
Okay, whatever. I will just stop when you tell us to stop.
Oh, okay, I like that idea.
The next one is a scissor kick, but we're adding the weight. It could be up here. If this starts to hurt your neck, bring it down on your chest. You're still getting that resistance. You can support your neck and continue to do the scissor kick. Okay?
All ready?
We're ready.
And go.
Trying to bring those legs down to at least 45 degree angle. No further up than the 90 degree angle. Straight legs if you can. If you can't, you can bend your legs if that's easier. Tyron's dancing.
Nope, you can't see it. It's not happening.
That neck is starting to bother me, so I'm just gonna put that weight right here.
30 seconds down. Are you gonna go 45 seconds?
Whatever you need.
Oh, whoa.
You're the boss.
How about you guys? Can you guys go 45 seconds? Okay, here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Nice job, nice job.
Okay, now we're gonna do some planks. Okay, we're gonna start off to get us, I could say, ready for these side planks. We're just gonna do a front plank. Let's say 30 seconds on the front plank, and then we'll do 45 on the sides. Okay?
Ready? And so you said 2 minutes on the...
It's gonna be 2 minutes once we get done with all of them.
Okay, ready, and go.
Okay. If you're on your knees, that's fine. Put out your toes. Or if not, come up with me on your toes. Try not to let your upper body lift up. We want to get as much out of this as we can. Come completely flat. This is for your entire core, your stomach and your back.
Good job. 3 minutes left.
Where are we?
30 seconds.
We did 30 seconds?
Yep.
Okay. All right. Next, side plank, where we're gonna scissor our legs and come up. If you need to, you can bend that bottom leg. That's okay. You're still getting some work in your core. Okay? And if it is bent, you can still do the exercise with it, elbow to knee, or you're gonna use that bottom leg for support and go elbow to knee.
Ready, and go. Nice exercise.
Nice one to watch.
Great.
side and then we're done. Scissor legs.
Ready?
Or bring the bottom one down. Yes.
And go.
Sometimes I feel the second side much faster than the first side.
Oh, I wonder why that is.
Because those muscles were engaged on both sides.
Okay, less than 10 seconds, everybody. You're almost home free.
We can do it. Oh, I'm losing my balance.
Keep it up, Sarah. You're doing great. And relax. Nice. All right.
Good. Okay. So there you have it. There's your Wednesday class. We hope you guys all really enjoyed that. I know we've had a good time. Again, let us know if these are beneficial for you and if you're doing it, if you're actually following it all the way to this end, we really appreciate it. Again, we've got
219 calories.
Whoa. That's more than I did. All right. So hopefully you guys are burning calories too. We'll see you guys day after tomorrow. And again, we're counting down the days until what we hope is the 18th when we will open up again. And so until next time, we'll see you guys later. Bye-bye.
Bye.